Hey Edwin, what are you doing with your hands?
Oh, Marco, I'm playing with the demo running on the STM32 development kit.
Nice, this runs super fluid. Especially the hand tracking works pretty well. But to be honest, I have seen this before.
Yes, that's what many people say, and many people have seen it on YouTube already. But most of the time what they have seen is running on GPUs or running in the cloud. Here we're running it on a microcontroller.
A microcontroller? Does it have enough power to run AI-based computer vision applications?
Yes, this one does, because it's the STM32N6. It's the first STM32 where we embed the neural art AI accelerator.
Okay, so you have an AI accelerator in the device. What performance boost are we talking about here then?
Yes, exactly. So we get there's an AI accelerator, so we're talking about acceleration. Not a few times, we're talking about 600 times acceleration compared to our highest end STM32.
Cool. So AI-based vision applications can now run on a ST microcontroller.
Yes, now we can do them on a microcontroller. So thanks to the neural art, so here we have the 600 times, the 600 GOPS worth of processing power. So that opens the door to audio processing, to computer vision. And talking about computer vision, we also integrated an image signal processing pipeline on this device.
Okay, what do you exactly mean by pipeline?
Okay, in terms of image pipeline and to support a large number of cameras out there, we have embedded a MIPI CSI2 interface and also an image signal processor. So that means that we do the raw Bayer conversion to RGB in hardware. We also provide camera tuning tools that customers can use to tune all the parameters of the computer vision pipeline.
Okay, that's a smart decision from ST to integrate an ISP into the device. So I guess our users will like the flexibility and the cost optimization of the device. What about the CPU power performance itself?
Okay, the CPU itself is based on the Cortex M55. So the Cortex M55 clocked at 800 megahertz, and also that's where the N6 is the high runner. It's the highest frequency we've seen on an STM32 so far.
800 megahertz on a microcontroller?
Absolutely.
This is quite a lot. So, how much memory did you integrate into the device?
Of course, these kind of applications, when we're talking about computer vision, they require a lot of memories. So here we have 42 megabytes of embedded SRAM. On top of the local tightly coupled memories to the Cortex M55 and local caches to the Cortex M55. So 42 megabytes of SRAM locally centrally in the system can be used by the AI part or by any of the multimedia accelerators we have in there.
And especially interested in the graphics, because again it runs quite smoothly. So I guess you have a kind of GPU integrated in the device or hardware accelerator for the graphics?
Yes, there are several multimedia accelerators in there. So we have graphics, 2.5D graphics acceleration, so offloading the main CPU for graphics workloads. So that's for snappy human-machine interfaces that can be augmented by the AI part. And on top of that, other multimedia accelerations are JPEG encode and decode, and we have H.264 encoding.
Okay, that's very important for video streaming applications. So it seems there's a lot of power packed into the device. And I see a lot of connectors here. What about the standard peripherals, like do you have, I guess, USB and stuff like that?
Okay, so this is a high-end microcontroller, so part of our high-performance portfolio. So there we paid a lot of attention to have the latest peripherals in there, and they are very numerous. So we have gigabit Ethernet on there. We have dual high-speed USB. We have CAN-FD. And then on top of course, the standard peripherals, which you can find the UART, CSPI, I2C, ICCC. So many, many peripherals out there.
Interesting. So it looks like this device can be really a game changer. What about the cost and the ease of use for the programmers?
As we talked earlier, that this is a microcontroller, so it comes with the advantages that a microcontroller has. So reduced BOM cost, easier to make PCBs, smaller footprint, faster boot time. So from that perspective, being a microcontroller comes with a lot of advantages. And for the developers also, they can use the Cube ecosystem that is available for the STM32, so CubeMX and also CubeAI to map your AI network to the accelerator.
Okay, and I guess you know for some complex applications you need a kind of operating system running on it. So what operating systems are supported by the device, and do you support the Zephyr project?
Yes, we do support Zephyr. We have several customers that are using Zephyr already. On top of Zephyr, we are supporting FreeRTOS and ThreadX.
Cool. I also read that ST is founding the Zephyr project, which is a wise decision from ST. So, Edwin, I really would love to play with this kit. How do I get it?
Well, Marco, working for one of the most important distributors out there, Avnet Silica, you must have no problem getting your hands on such a device. Marco, you have been looking at this one for a couple of minutes here, and I have the impression you really want it. So, you know what, I'm going to leave this one with you.
Thank you, Edwin. I'll promise I'll dive into the embedded AI world, and especially in the ST microcontroller world.
Great, looking forward to seeing what you do with it.